Hey everyone, today I am going to share a competitive programming secret with you. If you're a competitive programmer, then this video is very important for you. In today's video, I am going to cover what is TLE, why TLE occurs, and how to overcome TLE. And we are going to start right there. What is TLE? TLE stands for time limit exceeded, which is also referred by timeout error in common language. Why TLE occurs? Whenever you submit your solution, it will go to the server, and their online judge will execute your program and try to validate your program output against predefined test cases in a given time frame, which is set by the problem setter for a particular problem. If your program is unable to finish within a given time frame, or it's in middle of executing the test cases, in that case judge will issue kill command to your program, and throw TLE for some or all the test cases, which are not yet validated by the online judge. Here, your program was compiled successfully, but it didn't stop before the time limit. This may be because either algorithm is badly designed, too slow, or it contains a bug, example it goes into an infinite loop, or hangs up, expecting some input data. I hope you have got the idea by now why TLE occurs. Let's move on to next point. How to overcome TLE? In today's word, the computer can easily solve 10 raised to the power 8 operations in a second in the worst case. And we are also going to use the same fact to get rid of TLE. Now we know the online judge is also a program, which is running on a server or computer, and it has at most 1 second time for our program to validate. So, our intention will be to write the program in such a way, so that it will not take more than 1 second to complete for given constraints. There are two things which highly impact your program performance in contests. 1. Algorithm. 2. Input-output. Let's talk about algorithm first. How to choose the right algorithm? Look for the constraints given in a problem statement, and come up with an algorithm which can pass all test cases in a second. Here is the cheat sheet which will help you to understand well in more detail. If the input size is less than equal to 10 raised to the power 18, then log n algorithm will solve the problem within a second. Example binary search. If the input size is less than equal to 10 raised to the power 8, then you have to come up with an algorithm which is less than or equal to O n to solve the problem in a second. Example linear search. If the input size is less than equal to 10 raised to the power 6, then at max O n log n algorithm can be applied to solve the problem in a second. Example merge sort, building segment tree. If the input size is less than equal to 10 raised to the power 4, then O n square algorithm will require solve the problem. Example bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, 2 nested for loop. If the input size is less than equal to 2000, then at max O n square log n algorithm can be used to solve the problem. Example 2 nested loops and a tree related DS. And so, on etc. There is one more sheet which will show a different perspective of the same. Here you can see, based on input how much operation an algorithm has to perform, and highlighted the maximum operation which can be performed by the specific algorithm in a second. If the input is 10, O log n algorithm has to perform 3.3 operation or instruction, but O n algorithm will have to process 10 operation for the same. And O n log n algorithm will have to process 33 operations and so on. The cell highlighted in green depicts the maximum instructions or operations that can be processed by the CPU for that particular algorithm against given input. Let's do some exercise. Here is the problem statement, write your own sorting algorithm to sort an array of n integers, in ascending order, without using any library. Input format: the first line contains integer n, the size of the array. The second line contains n space separated integers describing the unsorted array. Constraints: n is greater than equal to 1 and less than equal to 10 raised to the power 6. Output format: print the array as a space separated integer in ascending order. Sample input 5, 5, 3, 6, 8, 9. Sample output 3, 5, 6, 8, 9. Algorithm 1: if you use bubble sort, you are bound to get TLE because bubble sort algorithm complexity is O n square. And as we know, the computer can perform 10 raised to the power 8 operation in a second. So, O n square algorithm need to process 10 raised to the power 12 operation, which will take 1 second into 10 raised to the power 4, which is equal to 2.77 hours. Algorithm 2: if you use merge sort, your algorithm will run within a second because merge sort complexity is O n log n. If you simplify this, it will approximately 10 raised to the power 6 into log 10 raised to the power 6 base 2. Into 10 raised to the power 7, which is less than 10 raised to the power 8. Operations which can be easily performed within a second by the computer. So, merge sort is the right choice here. This is how we should come up with the right algorithm before implementing it to save our time and effort. Input-output: sometimes input-output can also be a bottleneck which will cause TLE. You should always use fast input-output in coding contest, like in C++ we have scanf, printf, fast IO, and in Java we have buffered reader. In other programming languages also will have some alternatives which will help you to read fast. Note to constraints on the time limit also depends on the language on which you are coding. Every programming language may have different execution time, which is set by the problem setter. If C++ program takes 1 second, Java might take 2 second and Python might take 4 second. Because Python is a slow language and C++ are relatively fast because they are being closer to the hardware. But the concept will remain the same to analyze and come up with the correct algorithm which can pass all test cases. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you want more video like this in future, please like, comment and share this video with your friends. And do not forget to subscribe this channel.